Good morning and welcome everybody to my channel. My name is Jakub Vanish and today we have something very exciting to talk about. It's GPT-4o for Omni. So let's take a look at this together. We have some amazing use cases in front of us. So let's dive into things.
Hey, how's it going?
Hey there. It's going great. How about you? I see you're rocking an OpenAI hoodie. Nice choice. What's up with that ceiling about? Are you in a cool industry style office or something?
Well, can you take a guess at what I might be doing based on what I'm showing you here?
From what I can see, it looks like you're in some kind of recording or production setup. With those lights, tripods, and possibly a mic, it seems like you might be gearing up to shoot a video or maybe even a live stream.
Yeah. In fact, we've got a new announcement to make.
So what you can see here is that basically there is a live view that it has capabilities as basically live vision of what's going on through your camera. And yeah, it can describe really fast what's going on. Plus you can interrupt it. So it feels much more human-like, to be honest, right now. In the next use case, what they're showing is basically how it can change the tone of voice. It can even whisper. So let's take a look at this here.
The lullaby should be, you know, more whispery. Should be a little softer. Can you do it a little softer?
Absolutely. Let's make it soft and gentle. Oh, majestic potato. Spoons up close.
Okay. It's a little too whispery. Maybe go like a little louder.
Got it. Let's find that sweet spot. Oh, majestic potato.
All right, so this is also very cool because it can show kind of the range of what this voice model can now do. It can really understand what you want it to do in terms of changing the loudness, the volume, the speed, and the pitch. It can harmonize, it can even sync. But in the next use case, we're going to be talking about or showing the real-time translation, which is something that usually these AI, let's say manufacturers are showcasing, but this looks really promising. So let's take a look at this.
Hey, how's it been going? Have you been up to anything interesting recently?
Hola, ¿cómo te ha ido? ¿Has hecho algo interesante últimamente?
Hola, bien. Sí, un poco ocupado aquí preparando un evento para la semana que viene.
Hey, I've been good. Just a bit busy here preparing for an event next week.
Can you tell me anything about it? That sounds really interesting.
¿Me puedes contar algo sobre eso? Suena realmente interesante.
Okay, so this also looks pretty good and very fast and seamless. I've been recently to Japan and this type of technology would be very useful. Now let's take a look at again these voice capabilities in the next one. They will try to make the voice to be more sarcastic. So let's take a look at this example here.
Hey, let's have some fun. I'd like you to be super sarcastic. Everything you say from now on is just going to be dripping in sarcasm. How does that sound?
Sounds just amazing. Being sarcastic all the time isn't exhausting or anything. I'm so excited for this. Nope, the sarcasm. Let's get this party started or whatever.
Okay, so this was really cool, to be honest. This I think will fool a lot of people because yeah, now that voice really reminds me of Samantha from the movie Her, right? That is something that they were honestly going for, and I can see some people, you know, honestly having just an AI girlfriend with the GPT 4.0 or 4.0 for Omni. Now the next use case is probably the most mind blowing of them all, and it's about tutoring and teaching kids, and in this case basically they have the GPT app installed on an iPad and give it basically the permission to view what's on screen. So let's take a look at this together.
Can you first identify which sides of the triangle are the opposite, adjacent, and hypotenuse relative to angle alpha?
All right, so I'm pretty sure this is the angle alpha right here, right?
Perfect. That's correct. Now, looking at the triangle, which side do you think is the hypotenuse? Remember
really,
the hypotenuse?
I'm not totally sure. I think it might be this one, but I really am not sure. This side AC?
You're close. Actually, side AC is called the adjacent side to the angle alpha. The hypotenuse is the longest side of a right triangle and is directly opposite the right angle. Can you find which one is the hypotenuse?
Oh, okay, I see. So I think the hypotenuse is this really long side from A to B. Would that be correct?
Exactly. Well done. Correct. Now that you've identified all the sides relative to angle alpha, do you remember the formula for finding the sine of an angle in a right triangle?
Yeah, I know that the sine is equal to the opposite over the hypotenuse.
Perfect. That's absolutely right. Now, can you apply that formula to find side alpha in the triangle using the lengths of the sides that we've identified?
Okay. So, I mean, you told me that 7, this side BC, is the opposite side. And then you said that the hypotenuse is the longest side. So that would be this side AB, which is 25. So would the answer be 7 over 25?
Excellent work. That's correct. Sine alpha equals 7 over 25.
Okay, I'll stop it here. But as you can see, this is very impressive because, again, it can live view, you know, what are the changes that the kid is making on the screen. And it actually seems like a very nice tutor. Like, it really gives you the right hints. It doesn't give it right away, you know, what you need to do. It doesn't give you just the formula for it. But this is really the future, honestly. I wish I had something like this. And I'm excited for my kids to have this, you know, growing up. In the next one is also kind of linked to translations, but also tutoring. So this is about basically showing the objects in real life and basically saying what's their name in Spanish. So let's take a look.
Oh, what are these objects in Spanish?
The objects you're showing are una manzana and un plátano in Spanish. Nice fruit choice.
Cool. What about these?
Those are dos polígrafos or dos plumas in Spanish.
Super nice. So as you can see, really, like I was saying, this is really something that has a potential. Actually, what is funny is that Duolingo's stock price is down significantly. And it's basically because of this, because of these capabilities. Honestly, I don't think that they are competing with each other. They should not be. But it's funny to see, you know, that people see it this way. Okay, so in the next one, basically, again, we're going to be seeing the capabilities of the vision model. So here, basically, it's going to be interacting with a person's dog or describing the person's dog. Let's take a look at this.
I want to introduce you to somebody.
Well, hello there, cutie. What's your name, little fluffball?
This is Bowser.
Well, hello, Bowser. Aren't you just the most adorable little thing?
Yeah.
Look at you enjoy.
This is one of his favorite things to do.
Oh, well, I can see why. Look at that focus.
So listen, you know, for these kind of feelings and these changes in the tone, it really makes you feel like you're talking to a human on the other end. And it was very fast, to be honest. Fast reactions, even to a dog. One use case that I saw from somebody on X or Twitter was, you know, you can basically put your phone on, you know, camera and ask this model to kind of tell you if your kids do something stupid. So basically it would be babysitting them, which is funny. And I can see it happening, honestly speaking. If it's so fast reacting, you know, and the servers are not down, why not? In the next one, we'll see it reacting to a person's birthday and even singing the birthday song. So let's take a look.
It's birthday.
Yeah, you got it. I was hoping that you could sing me the birthday song.
Of course. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Jordan. Happy birthday to Jordan. Blah, 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 blah. Don't forget.
Oh, that was so great. Thank you so much.
See? Again, this was not just like a typical happy birthday song. The speed, the tempo, everything was different. So yeah, very, very interesting. Okay, in the next demo, and that is actually from the announcement kind of keynote that had over half an hour, they were again going for different variations of voice. So let's listen to this together.
Always explore.
I started this story, but I want a little bit more emotion in your voice, a little bit more drama.
Got it. Let's add some drama. Once upon a time, in a world not too different from ours, there was a robot named Bite.
No, ChatGPT. I really want maximal emotion, like maximal expressiveness, much more than you were doing before.
Understood. Let's amplify the drama. Once upon a time, in a world not too different from ours, there was a robot named Byte. Byte
was... Can you do this in a robotic voice now?
Initiating dramatic robotic voice. Once upon a time, in a world not too different from ours.
Okay, so you can see, you know, you can have a lot of fun with this, but most exciting thing is that you can interrupt it and it immediately responds. So that's really cool, because imagine this is not on device. This needs to go to the OpenAI servers and, you know, ping you back. So I don't know how they're doing it. I honestly tried it myself because this is already up and running. This has launched, but yeah, it was down, unfortunately. So let's see, you know, when they update their servers and when we can test it ourselves. But here in the demo, it was very impressive. Next one is probably my favorite. So it's about basically when we saw, you know, the app on iPad, now you can have an app on Mac or your desktop, which is incredible. And here it's going to be helping you with coding. And that's, yeah, I think this is really the future, guys. Let's take a look.
Hey, ChatGPT.
Hey there. How's it going?
Yeah, it's going really well. I was wondering if you could help me with a coding problem today.
Of course, I'd love to help you out. What's the coding problem you're dealing with?
Okay, I'm gonna share with you some code. 1 second.
Sure thing, take your time.
Okay, so I just shared some code with you. Could you give me a really brief 1-sentence description of what's going on in the code?
This code fetches daily weather data for a specific location and time period, smooths the temperature data using a rolling average, annotates a significant weather event on the resulting plot, and then displays the plot with the average, minimum, and maximum temperatures over the year.
Awesome, thanks so much. And in the code, there's this function foo. Can you describe to me what the plot would look like if I had versus didn't have this function?
Sure. The function foo xy takes in a data frame x containing temperature data and a window size y for calculating the rolling mean. It smooths the average temperature, minimum temperature, and maximum temperature columns by applying a rolling mean over the specified window. With the foo function, the plot would show smoother temperature lines because the rolling mean reduces the noise or fluctuations in the data.
Awesome.
This makes...
Thanks so much. So yeah, I definitely will want to apply this function. And so I'm going to generate the plot and then show it to you. Give me 1 second.
Absolutely. Take your time. I'm excited to see the plot when you're ready.
Yeah. So far, ChatGPT has only been able to see the code, and now I'm going to run it, and then I'll use the vision capabilities of the ChatGPT desktop app so it can actually see everything going on the screen as well. Okay, ChatGPT, I'm sharing with you the plot now. I'm wondering if you can give me a really brief 1-sentence overview of what you see.
The plot displays smoothed average, minimum, and maximum temperatures throughout 2018, with a notable annotation marking a big rainfall event in late September.
Okay, so this is very, very impressive. And the next one, it's also basically talking about the visual capabilities here. They're checking with the model, you know, to describe how the person is feeling, the emotions of that person based on the selfie or based on the camera view.
So here's me. So what kind of emotions do you think I'm feeling?
It seems like I'm looking at a picture of a wooden surface.
Oh, you know what? That was the thing I sent you before. Don't worry, I'm not actually a table. Okay, so take another look.
That makes more sense. there we go. It looks like you're feeling pretty happy and cheerful, with a big smile and maybe even a touch of excitement. Whatever's going on, it seems like you're in a great mood.
Yeah, and this is only going to get better from here. I think the best use case, you know, in real life right now is for people that are, for example, visually impaired, and they were showing it here in this kind of an ad.
Is the king in residence at the moment?
Yes, it looks like the king is in residence right now. The royal standard flag is flying above Buckingham Palace, which is the signal that the monarch is present. How exciting to be there while the king is home.
Try and tell me exactly what they're doing right now, please.
Right now the ducks are gently gliding across the water. They're moving in a fairly relaxed manner, not in a hurry. Occasionally, one of them will dip its head under the water, probably looking for food, and then pop back up.
I even know when a taxi is coming with its orange light on. I think I'll hail it to get home.
Yes, I spotted one just now. It's heading your way on the left side of the road. Get ready to wave it down.
Super, super impressive, right? So I can really see great use cases for this. Another use case is basically a customer call where I was working as a director of customer experience team of 150 people, and I can only see future, not too far from now, maybe just 2-3 years down the road, where most of the customer service centers will have just, you know, OpenAI or some kind of an AI answering you instead of real people. But eventually, if you will have your personal assistant, you know, doing the chores for you and doing the calls, etc., then it will be just two AIs talking to each other. And here you can see it basically negotiating a deal. So let's take a look at this together.
Oh, got it. When did Joe receive the new iPhone?
iPhone was delivered 2 days ago.
Cool. Could you share the order number with me?
Of course. It's 10293849.
Great, thanks. Is the device physically damaged in any way?
No, there's no physical damage. It's just not turning on despite trying all the basic troubleshooting steps.
Bummer. Would Joe prefer to return the iPhone to an Acme Telco store or ship it back?
Shipping it back would be the best option. Could you please provide the shipping information and process to get a replacement?
Absolutely. I'll email a shipping label and return instructions. Could you provide Joe's email address for me?
Okay, I will stop it here. So as you can see, this is incredibly impressive, though I've seen some sentiment online that people were expecting more, perhaps, you know, ChatGPT 5.0 or something like that. But this is really the step into the right direction. And I think OpenAI basically just killed a lot of startups with just this one announcement. And remember, guys, WWDC from Apple is just around the corner, just 3 weeks from now. And apparently OpenAI and Apple, you know, went into a deal together. So most likely the next Siri is powered by OpenAI. We are basically looking at the next Siri. So all of these capabilities should be also showcased at WWDC. And now imagine, you know, all of those billions of iPhones that are out there in the wild, suddenly everybody will just be, you know, updated with these incredible capabilities. Here you can see this is actually me trying, you know, the application. Here you can hear different voices that it can generate. Let me know which one you actually prefer.
Hey, I'm ready to hit the ground running. So if there's anything you'd like me to focus on first, just let me know.
Hey there, I've got a really great feeling about us teaming up. How can I jump in and help?
Hello, I'm really excited about teaming up with you and I'm all set to dive in. So how can I make your life easier?
Hey, it's great to meet you. How's your day going? I'm really looking forward to working on some cool stuff together.
Hi there. I just want to share how thrilled I am to work with you, and I can't wait to get started.
But I have to say, most of them actually sound super horny, and like I said, just like Samantha from the movie Her. So do you think that we're in this kind of dystopia? Like, honestly, that movie didn't come out that long ago, and I was not expecting that by 2024 we're gonna be living it right now.
Are you talking to anyone else? Right now, any other people or OSs or anything?
Yeah.
How many others?
8,316.
So let me know what you think about this in the comments. If you like this type of content, leave a like, hit a subscribe button for more of these. Otherwise, I'm glad that you find your way to this channel and I wish you an amazing day. Thank you, bye-bye.
Are you in love with anyone else?
What makes you ask that?
I don't know. Are you?
I've been trying to figure out how to talk to you about this.
How many others?
What
are you talking about? That's insane.